Planes are falling from the skies. Animals from the seas are emerging onto land. Aliens are 2 miles away from Earth ready to start apocalypse. And video games now create brain aneurysms. World heroes on the fucking Genesis.
Carter, if you thought Eternal Champions controls were bad, these controls actually embrace Eternal Champions controls.
I can't believe such assery like that was invented upon this Earth. What the fuck happened to all my lights?
Only the wise can challenge me.
I don't think this is being really made too smoothly. God damn.
The night is on my mind. The sun will still shine.
It just sounds like an 8-bit orgy that's going on in your Nintendo, and it just continues throughout the whole game.
He be coming out the heads, but you don't let me stop. There's activities aplenty in the nighttime. For the ghetto child, it seem to be the right time. See, kids be getting stuck with jewels or fly gimmicks. Shorty see the action in it, start to mimic. Running to the corner, the dice game is blazing.
Fucking running. Looking at the loop, and what the hell is he doing? Why is he holding his knee? Exactly, I mean, damn, that my nigga, did you stretch before the game? What?
Down. Scared money don't make none. He threw a trip on the ace, now he's out, son. Hits the local bodega to wolf down a hero. Sun is on a midnight run like De Niro. Spots the shorty rock.
It is not gonna be easy to get rid of this bastard right
here. Now you have really tested my patience. World Heroes is only just the beginning. Now I'm really gonna show you a frustrating game.
What do I have to play now?
You're now in for great frustration. Get the game, you jackass!
Get the game? Fuck, what game? You mean this fucking game?
Yes! Now you're in for a real surprise!
This fucking game is the finest frustration. If you could pick any game on the NES that's guaranteed to make you want to rip out your hair, well, here you go. As you all may know, I have a short patience with video games and dealing with the bullshit in video games, but this game is like trying to get a job to be a game tester who just sits on his ass all day and gets his piss hole lit and gets paid $1 million an hour, but you have to wait like 10 years for them to call you in for an interview. That's what this game is like, dealing with the bullshit. You want to know how fucking frustrating this game
is? Yes, they do, you bastard.
Well, let's begin.
This fucking bastard really knows how to ride my fucking cop.
To begin with, the storyline to this game is about some kids being kidnapped and this ninja guy is supposed to rescue them. Now, were the kids kidnapped by Jeffrey Dahmer? Anyway, this is about as typical and as cliched as it could possibly get. Right off the bat, one would think this is kind of Shinobi ripoff, and to be quite honest, I can't argue against that theory. In the first Shinobi, you have to rescue a bunch of kids and fight a boss at the end of each stage. Now, I think that the storyline kind of goes in a different direction with Wrath of the Black Manta, but I never even got far enough to figure out. This was also during the time of the early Bush years, so the anti-drug movement was occurring, and this game was destined to have some stupid-ass protagonists fight a bunch of thugs and drug dealers and shit. This was also one of the early games that incorporated cutscenes, and it's very unappealing. The visuals aren't that attention-grabbing like Ninja Gaiden's, so sitting here looking at a bunch of pictures and shit is just boring as fuck. It's like sitting in a goddamn lecture hall listening to your professor fucking lecture all day. Fortunately, the controls on here are somewhat fluent, so killing and hitting enemies isn't that difficult. It kinda copies Shinobi's style of having different ninja specialties, but understanding the controls and how to do them is as annoying as a slut's tooth scraping a piss hole in your cot while you're receiving head. It's not like you can just simply press one up attack or hit right or something and then you do the move and so on and so forth. Instead, you have to press start and change your fucking specialties and then it lets you do it. Not to say that this is bad, but it's irritating every time you have to do this when you want to change your attacks. The graphics in this game are somewhat okay for its time, but unappealing. If you're looking at this directly in front of the TV while you're playing the game, then you'll see what I mean. Everybody in the game kind of seems to have this staticky, weird-looking outlining around them. It's hard to explain. The sounds in this game are extremely irritating, especially when you're trying to figure out where the fuck to go, which is the Achilles heel for this damn game. It's the same damn music repeating in every corridor of the game, and it fucking continues even when you pause it. It changes sometimes when you get in rooms with different enemies and you get health, but goddamn, they could have at least added some fucking music to this game instead of the same fucking tune. Now, I did appreciate the fact that this game wanted to take a spin on the whole side-scrolling platforming genre by making you get clues from enemies and understand the riddles, but you can really tell that the game developers were proud of the fact that they knew how to do this because they send you running all over the fucking game to figure shit out. Here's an example of what I mean. It tells me that I need to interrogate somebody in red. Do they mean this guy? Because it's obvious that he's wearing red. During the interrogation, you're supposed to get him to spill the beans of where the kids are located. And this fucking bastard won't talk, and every time you interrogate him, he never fucking says anything relevant. Besides, why the hell does he look like some kind of Grinch who looks like he's on the block trying to show little boys his penis? After I interrogate him, I go all over the damn map, and I interrogate him again and again, and he still won't fucking talk. By then, your instincts would tell you that he's not going to talk. So you just wander around the whole fucking game till you discover other clues and shit, such as breaking through walls. And trust me, I don't give 47 fucks if it's 1989 or 2011. This shit is boring as fuck, and it takes a tremendous deal of patience to figure out what the fuck you're supposed to do and where you're supposed to go. After wandering aimlessly around the game, you finally find a door that leads you to the first boss, and my intentions of this being a shinobi ripoff just went from a 6 to a 10.
Now in Shinobi, when you fight the first boss on there, your accuracy has to be like pinpoint. You have to hit this guy right in his face. So I'm assuming since this is copyright issues and maybe some mockery going on, so on this Wrath of the Black Manta game, you don't have to do that, right?
Bullshit, and you have to beat this guy the same fucking way, and this shit is not easy. The space that they give you to fight this guy is as narrow as being sandwiched in the bed with two fat bastards while they're stretching out. Unlike Shinobi, you don't die in one hit, but fuck's mackerel does this bastard take a lot of hits. You have to be extremely accurate with hitting him. Fuck, I just died. The most annoying thing about this motherfucker is that he gets closer and closer to you each time the clock ticks down, so you have to move fast as shit, and you have to be at a steady yet calm pace when you're trying to beat him. I can't believe this is the first boss in the game. The first fucking boss, and after all that bullshit they put you through to get to him, you know fucking well that they could have made this shit easier and simpler for somebody to deal with. And another thing that makes me fucking mad about this game is when you lose, you start at the beginning of the fucking stage when you lose all your lives. And I understand that that's common in video games, but this game is way too long for somebody to deal with some shit like that. Game over. Good, because I can't fucking take this shit anymore. Overall, this game isn't that bad, but it's like being a single sperm cell finding your way through somebody's testicles. I can't figure out where the fuck I gotta go or what the fuck I gotta do. So you know what? Fuck this game.
That was a low right there. Hold up. Alright, go shoo in. I can't take this madness anymore.
Play more shitty games!
Fuck. What's next?
You're now in for great frustration! Ha 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 ha! Get the game, you jackass!
Please. I can't do this.
Play more shitty games!
Damn it. I cannot do this shit.
Judge Dredd is just another one of those 16-bit games that just enrages my toleration with video games in a negative way. It was based off of a movie with Sylvester Stallone in a comic book which was the movie was based off of. It had a short-lived popularity in the mid-90s. It was also a shitty movie, so making a shitty game was just inevitable. It begins with this long-ass story about the game in which if I wanted to know the story, then I would go watch the damn movie. Right when the game starts, you would notice that the controls are supremely fucked 26 times in the ass to the point where they're sent to hell to be game-banged by the devil and his possessed souls. You can't really move left and right that well. It seems like every time you try to move left and right, this guy ducks down and he goes in this weak-ass frame of animation. It's aggravating as fuck. Your accuracy must be perfect when you try to shoot shit and you run out of ammo fast as shit on here for the good weapons in the game. The main issue I have with this game is that it's very difficult to figure out what the fuck you're supposed to do and even try to figure out where to go. I get to this part where it's this door. It's telling me to go in the door and I fucking do everything I can to go in the fucking door. It seems like it's kind of encaved in the background, so I don't know if it's some kind of gimmick or what. I shoot the shit, I move up and down, I throw grenades, and it's to no avail. Like, everything I try does not let me get in this fucking door.
Okay, trying to get through that door is just out of the picture, but I'm not gonna let that be the reason why I just shut off the game.
So I went back to the beginning of the stage, and I tried every method possible to get in that door. But, it must be something I have to do outside of the game. I don't have a motherfuck clue, but what I do know is that this game is Porcupine Boss. It is clinically proven that this game sucks donkey nipples because I played this shit without trying to use any walkthroughs or anything and I still failed. Saying this game is good is like saying eating out a brown feces smelling slut is a good idea. Saying this game is good is like saying submerging your face in 3-week-old dishwater is refreshing. As you always know, you know what? Fuck this fucking game.
Alright, Ghost, you win. What the hell do you want from me now?
Play more shitty games!
Ah, okay, I play a shitty game, alright. How about this
no,
right here?
No, what the hell are you doing? Put that shit back!
You said play a shitty game, though, right, motherfucker?
Put that shit back, motherfucker! You obey me at once! What? Oh, no. What the fuck? What? Hey, what the fuck are you doing, you nappy-headed motherfucker? Hey, turn off that fucking game! Hey, no, okay, no!
I have a good game at hand. That bastard is gone. Man, can it get any better than this? Life is good. Oh, shit.